So look at my view, what I have to deal with.
And that's the direction I need to be at to get this God's eye.
Okay, as you just saw outside, that's my guide camera. It can barely see through the outside wall.
Still,
at 3 minutes exposure time, I'm still able to get a shot after doing a meridian flip. Let's just see how this turns out.
Is frame number 12? Frame number 12 is coming up.
Bola.
Not bad. Let's do an auto stretch on this. God's eye. Yeah. Okay. We're looking good.
Despite that my guide camera can barely see that star, but we're doing good. It's been a rough night, well, early morning. Tried to go after M101. I can only finish the HA under, and then the trees got in the way. And then I went over to the Helix I. And the trees got in the way there. All I got was HA. Then I slew over to M33. I couldn't wait for it to clear the tree line, so I said, screw this. I'm going to go north to the Cassiopeian constellation, and I'm gonna go after the Owl Galaxy, NGC 457. Here's my task. HA, oxygen, sulfur, and UVIR. This is gonna last about 3 hours, and right now it's 3:40. I seriously doubt I'll be able to get all three Hubble paths. I'll be able to complete the Hubble palette because I think sunrise is at 6 something, but everybody will be up and I will be sleeping. Here's the results. This is frame number 2 of HA. Here is the... Can someone tell me the reason why when you do plate solving? They use a white background. And here's my plate solving right there with UVIR. And I click on this. Here's my ET galaxy, or my monkey galaxy, or my owl nebula, owl galaxy. Let's do a stretch. Let's see what it looks like. This may look pretty cool. All right, that's a low stretch.